Hello and welcome. My name is John Dickinson for Boris Effects, and in this Particle Illusion tutorial, we're going to look at the controls window, specifically emitter properties and parameters, and how you can use them to customize the particles in your scene. Okay, so let's start by adding an emitter to our stage. I'm going to search for rose and double click rose petals fall 01. Now this is a line emitter, so it's placed the first point in the center of my stage, and I need to double click to place the second point. So I'll just double click there and grab the first point and bring it up above the viewable area. If you just press play, these particles will fall down into the viewable area. So by adding that emitter to the stage, it's placed it inside layer one. But layers can contain more than one emitter. So let's search for another one. I'm going to search for Pixie and double click Pixie Dust. And you can see that's placed that above the rose petals emitter in the layer stack. Now, Pixie Dust is a point emitter. Need to make a few adjustments. So I'll twirl open properties and I'll change this to line. And just bring this one in about the same position as the rose. I'm just bringing them up slightly above the viewable area so that we don't see them as they're being born, only as they're falling into view. So if I just zoom in here, you can see they're very small, so I need to make them larger. But first of all, I'll just decrease the number. Probably way too many there. Just make a few minor adjustments and just increase the size. That's not too bad. And if I just press play, we'll see how they're falling. Okay, they're falling okay, but they're not lasting long enough. So I just need to increase the life. Just bring that up a bit, and there's probably way too many now. So now I need to bring the number right down. Okay, maybe something like that. Just come back to the start. They're a little bit heavy, aren't they? So maybe the weight is too much. And just increase the life just a little bit more. All right. So now with two emitters in the layer, if we come up to the layer and adjust position XY, that will move all of the emitters inside the layer. And maybe change the angle. So you can make global adjustments. Okay, so now let's take a closer look at the emitter controls. I'm going to delete Pixie Dust, and let's start by taking a closer look at these properties. Now, as I mentioned, this is a line emitter. Other emitter shapes include point, ellipse, area, and circle, and the one you choose will depend on the look that you're trying to create. Each of these has common parameters and also some shape-specific parameters. If I choose area, you can see how emission in and emission out is no longer available, because that's specific to line. And point only has the common parameters, the first one being frames to preload. You might also know this as pre-run. So if I increase this, watch what happens on the stage. Now I've changed that to point. I need to change that back to line. And just double click to reset that and bring that back to zero. So you can see even at zero, I'm seeing particles. Drop that back to zero again and no particles. So frames to preload is important if you need to have particles within the viewable area right from frame zero. For particle order, you have unordered by default, or you can choose to have the oldest particles in the back or the oldest particles in the front. Using tint color, we can change the tint color of the particles. If your particle shape is not white, then you might get unpredictable results. If I click on this and maybe choose a yellow, for example, and come down to tint strength and increase that to 100, notice how the particles have hardly changed. But if we come down to petals and we twirl open properties and change the shape image to something white, And then we change the tint color once again to a yellow and increase the tint strength. Then you'll see them change color. So I'll just undo that. So definitely something to keep in mind when you're using a shape image that isn't white. The last common parameter is random seed, which is very straightforward. And random seed is always useful, especially when you've duplicated the particle setup and you want to make the duplicate look slightly different. Beneath properties are various parameters, and the ones that you see here will depend on which shape you have chosen. There are certain common parameters, things like position XY and emission angle and range, and these are particularly useful when you're using the point emitter, and also tint strength, which I've already mentioned. These other parameters are scale factors for the particle parameters with the same name. And these are useful for making overall adjustments to those key particle parameters. And they do affect all particles in this emitter. If I just click on Petals and click on the hamburger menu and choose Duplicate Particle Type, and then for the duplicate, just change that particle type just by twirling down Properties, clicking on Shape Image, and maybe just choosing a star, just like that. Maybe just change the size of that. If I now change the weight for the emitter, watch what happens to the particles. All of those particles inside the emitter's weight is increased by this scale factor. So you'd use these when you've set up your particle types and you just want to make a few overall adjustments. One thing to keep in mind with this is that if the particle has a setting of 0, for example, down here motion random is set to 0, and I try and change motion random for the emitter, nothing actually changes. That's because the particle's value is 0. If I increase motion random for the particle, then when I change this value, you can see it actually has an effect on the particles. So that can be a little bit of a gotcha. You might come up here and make changes to one of these common parameters and see nothing happen in the stage. Just come down here to the particle and check that it's not on 0. The last thing of note for emitters is the hamburger menu. And this has a range of options. Here you can move this up or down in the stacking order if you have more than one emitter. And this will move it in front or behind on the stage as well. You can disable this emitter, duplicate or delete it. You can also convert this to a super emitter, something we cover in the Understanding Super Emitters tutorial. This is also where you can save your custom emitters to an emitter library. And you can also add a new particle type from here as well. You can see when I chose that, a new particle type was created. And this is handy if you want to have your particle type with just base settings and build it up from there. You can download Particle Illusion standalone for free at boriseffects.com, including thousands of free particle emitter presets. Continue watching this Getting Started tutorial series to learn more about what you can do with Particle Illusion and find out more about the plugin version of Particle Illusion with extra features, including built-in Mocha motion tracking at boriseffects.com.